Hi, everybody. Welcome to this week's edition of Map Shortcuts. My name is Josh Livni, and this is our first Map Shortcuts after Google I.O. 2013. So for those of you who were at Google I.O. or maybe watching it around the world on one of the live streams or the follow-up videos, I just want to let you know that we do have a new refresh look and feel for Google Maps. So if you go to maps.google.com, you can maybe you already have an invitation, maybe you're already in, or you can request an invitation and see what is really an amazing experience. And what I want to talk to you about today is how we're integrating that into the API for you guys, the developers, to sort of get the same look and feel of the maps, the new Google Maps, into your websites. So on our Geo Developers blog, we have a post kind of outlining a lot of details, which you might find interesting. The key here is the code, which I'll get into in a second, how you set it. And there's just a one-line piece of code that you can add to your website. And what will happen is you get the sort of look and feel of the new tiles and the sort of refreshed look of the new Google Maps on your API site. So before I go into the details there, I also want to point out a refreshed look and feel that we have for our map site on developers.google.com. So if you go to developers.google.com/maps, you'll see our new page. Check it out. It's quite nice. And the first thing I want to point out is we have a new job site. So if we go to the job site here, we can see if you're interested in working here, we have a lot of open positions and a lot of super exciting teams. Some of them we talked about in some detail what the teams are doing at Google I.O., so check out those YouTube videos. And the point here is if you go through the instructions to send in a resume packet, following pretty simple guidelines here, it'll go straight to the Maps team, and we'll take a look. It's a little bit different than if you're applying for a job at Google generally, and it might go to all of the potential teams, which is also great. But if you're interested in Maps specifically, check out this job site. So the second thing I want to go into is how do you enable this visual refresh on your site? And if we go to our documentation here for our JavaScript API, under the Developer's Guide, go to our basic concepts. We've added a new section at the top with a visual refresh. So you can see on the left and right a slightly different look and feel between these maps. I'll get into the details of that a little bit more. The point here is to enable the visual refresh, all you need to do is set google.maps.visualrefresh equals true at some point in your JavaScript before you instantiate and render the map. So as long as you set that parameter to be true, we'll have all of the map tiles and so forth with a new look and feel for your page. So super easy. OK, let's get into some of the details of what the differences are between the old and the new feel. So here's the new look and feel on my old hometown of Seattle. And one thing you'll notice as I zoom out, this cool site that our friends at UbiLabs put together, it's really simple, kind of mouse over, mouse out. You can see the look and feel of change as you go in and out. So thanks to the UbiLabs guys for that. I'll just give you a quick example of some different areas. If we zoom in, some of the most obvious things we can see is the watercolor changes slightly, the icons change. Overall, the colors are just kind of cleaner, and it's a more kind of clean look and feel in general. Some of the other details are, especially for you guys developing websites, we've gotten rid of almost all of the shadows. So if you bring up an info window with the new look and feel, you're not going to see any shadows below that. And the code that you have specifically on the shadows panel will be ignored. Some of the other things are the default marker is slightly different. Obviously, we have new fonts and icons, slightly new colors, and new controls. So as I zoom in and out and you look at the controls, you'll see some subtle differences where we match the, again, the look and feel of the maps.google.com site. So a couple other things just to note is if you're using static maps, you can also use the new visual refresh look. So here is the standard static maps, again, of Seattle. And if I just change the URL to add visual refresh equals true, I'll go ahead and get the new map. So go ahead and play around with the new look and feel. We think it's a super nice UI design. And again, we have some talks at Google I.O. you can look at to see in detail some of the things that went into making these new tiles. And the very last thing I just want to mention is that we'll be changing the look and feel by default for you guys. So right now, you have to manually opt in. Starting on August 15, when we put out our next version of the Maps API, this new look and feel will be the default for our experimental branch. So if you load your JavaScript with experimental, then we will be pushing this out to all of you by default on August 15. And then 3 months later, when we put out the next version, it will be the default look and feel for our default branch. So mid-November, you should expect, if you're using our default branch, you'll also get it. So definitely recommend you guys check it out early. Check out the experimental branch after August. Or for now, you know, please go ahead and play around with it. Give us feedback. And we look forward to seeing lots more sites with a new look and feel. Thanks a lot. See you guys in a week.